In last part, we saw Zhu Xiao was giving her speech to her people to choose between death and betrayal. This winter came early. It was merely September, yet snow had already started falling. The light layer of snow was like a blanket of small white flowers that had just bloomed in spring. The Wei army retreated yet again. This was the third day of their encirclement and the large-scale assault that they had imagined had never happened. Yuan Yang had carefully surrounded the pass to prevent Zhu Xiao from escaping. His thought processes now were extremely complex. He feared that it was a trap that Yan Bei had laid. Yet he was worried that he would miss his golden opportunity, in which Yan Bei and Zhu Xiao had really turned against each other, such that he would ride the empire of Zhu Xiao, who was one of the most potent enemy generals. After all, the news of how Yan Shun and Zhu Xiao had fallen out in the past 2 years had already reached his ears. It was impossible that he was completely not privy to all the happenings. In the night, as the wind swept past, Zhu Xiao stood atop a tall hill overlooking the entire battlefield. The night wind sent her voluminous hair fluttering gracefully. The war had lasted for an entire 3 years. The Longin Pass had been constructed to be a few feet higher than Yamin Pass, towering above the two armies that were lying in wait. In between the two formations that solemnly waited for combat, there were large swaths of grass patched that were easily waist height. With the autumn breeze sweeping past, there was much rustling as though waves in a white ocean, reflecting the silvery moonlight in a beautiful spectacle. A flock of ravens flew past, lifting up a cloud of snow dust. One of them lightly darted into the tall grass and with one swift motion picked up something white and flew off. With only one glance, Zhu Xiao could already tell what the bird had picked up from the ground. Throwing her glance at the waves of white before her, a tinge of sadness and abomination emerged from her heart. Under this peaceful, swaying grass, how many lives had been lost? Like a man-eating tiger, war had gruesomely devoured countless men and women alike. The winds of this disturbed era would then blew past dilapidated houses, which had lost their owners, hollowing endlessly as though singing a song that had transcended through space-time from the underworld. Yet could Zhu Xiao be also considered as one of the masterminds behind such death and destruction? Ah, Zhu, a voice still echoed out within the darkness, as though calling her soul. Ah, Zhu, it was a voice she had heard daily for that past 2,000 nights. Gradually closing her eyes, countless recollections surfaced before her vision. She seemed to have been seeing so many people again. She saw the gentle yet righteous Mr. Wu, the calm and intelligent Lady Yu, the adorable and energetic Wan Huan, the kind and humble Xiao Hui. She also saw Xu Jingyuan, who had died in order to alert her, Wen Yang, who had died to protect their flag, and also Feng Ting, Mu Rong, and the Wu Dang Yu, who had charged into the enemy along and died to countless arrows. She even saw the face of the soldiers of Xiu Li army and countless Shangshen, Hui Hui mountains, and Beishao's civilians. Not stopping there, she even saw Chao Meng Tong, who had committed suicide, apologize for his mistake, and those rotten Datong elders. With no reinforcement, no food, in this freezing temperature, while protecting thousands of civilians who were completely unarmed, the Xiu Li army stood on guard as time passed. Yet the enemy was running out of patience as the winter was about to come and heavy snow was about to cover the entire land. Chu Xiao looked up at the sky and felt as though she saw a certain pair of eyes staring back at her. Those eyes had long ago sank into an abyss of coldness, silently watching her with no anger, no mockery, with only peace left in him as he repeated again and again, "Live on." "I know." Chu Xiao smiled at the empty skies and quietly said, "I will definitely hang on." Turning back, she saw the tents that were pitched in a neat formation. Calmly, she quietly declared, "I will definitely protect you." Beichang calendar year 778, autumn. Before long in pass, the Xia army had achieved the first full encirclement in history. With nearly 130,000 soldiers, Longin Pass had been completely surrounded with no way to escape. All kinds of long-distance weapons were transported, and it was obvious that an unfair battle would begin. Although 14th Prince Yuan Yang was facing Chu Xiao, who had defeated him twice in the Battle of Chindu and Beishao, he was not worried. Firstly, Long In Pass and Yamin Pass were relatively close, and he had sufficient reinforcements ready. Even if he discovered that he had fallen into a trap, he could easily head back to his fort. Secondly, Chu Xiao did not have any city that she had garrisoned, and neither did she have her powerful weapons. With merely 5,000 light cavalry and a bunch of civilians, she could never stand up to his 100,000 strong, heavily armed soldiers. Thirdly, the spies he had sent into Yanbei had finally sent intel. About a week ago, Yanshun had an interesting battle with Chu Xiao outside Beishao, resulting in the death of tens of thousands of soldiers. Not only that, but the Datong's official had all been killed or imprisoned, with only Chu Xiao left. If even that was still a trap, he could only say that Yan Shun was too merciless and was not someone he would handle anyway. In the dawn of September 18th, just as the sky started to light up, a wave of drums and military bugles sounded out. It was like a lightning that struck from the sky, piercing into the heart of the Xiu Li army and the civilians. Thank you for being there for me and subscribing my channel. Like the video to support me and to know the further story. See you guys in the next one. Thank you.